My name is Edgar Simard, and I'm a senior epidemiologist in the Surveillance Research Program at the American Cancer Society. The annual report to the nation on the status of cancer is published every year by a group of leading cancer surveillance scientists at the American Cancer Society, the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, the National Cancer Institute, and the North American Association of Central Cancer Registries. The major finding from this year's annual report is that the overall cancer death rate has continued to decline, a change that was first noted in the early 1990s. This decline was noted for men and women of every racial and ethnic group. We attribute a large proportion of the decline in the overall cancer death rate to declines in the most common cancers, such as reductions in lung cancer mortality due to decreases in tobacco consumption, as well as reductions in breast and colorectal cancer death rates due to increased screening and improved treatments. So we have seen progress in many cancers. However, during the most recent time period for which we have available data, that is 2000 through 2009, we've documented increases in the death rates for pancreas and liver cancers among both men and women, as well as for melanoma of the skin among men and uterine cancer among women. A special section of this year's annual report to the nation is focused on evaluating incidence trends for human papillomavirus, or HPV, associated cancers, as well as trends in HPV vaccination coverage levels. During 2000 through 2009, we found that the incidence of some HPV associated cancers increased. For example, cancer of the oral cavity and pharynx incidence rates increased among white men and women, and anal cancer incidence rates increased among white and black men and women. This is in contrast to cervical cancer incidence rates that have continued to decline among virtually all women. This report demonstrates continued progress in cancer prevention and control, as demonstrated by the declining cancer death rate. And we can achieve even greater progress in declining cancer death rates by applying what we know in terms of cancer prevention and control to even more people in the United States.